is every Bulldog's dream and every Hoosier's nightmare. Whose dreams will come true tonight? Welcome to Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, Indiana, as the Butler Bulldogs of the Horizon League, 6-4 in the season, take on the 17th-ranked Indiana Hoosiers. Hi again, everyone. Happy holidays. I'm Mike Adamley, along with former Indiana great John Leskowski. Glad you could join us for this little Hoosier showdown. You know, based on their last two games that they played, tonight's contest could turn into a three-point shooting contest. So let's take a look at the star watch, because both teams have a pair of sharpshooters that are pretty good. Bruce Horan of Butler and Marshall Strickland of Indiana, John.
There you see Bruce Horan. He's the all-time career leader in three-point field goals made for Butler. He'll be shooting it from outside the lane tonight. And Marshall Strickland, since he's moved to the shooting guard this year from point guard last year, his scoring is way up, his shooting much better.
Well, if Allen Iverson is the answer, well, this man for Indiana is the difference. Marco Killingsworth, the transfer from Auburn, has made Indiana a much tougher team to defend this year. It's Indiana versus Butler next.
Get two pair for $99 in about an hour. That's right. Choose two frames from iMart's huge selection of in-stock fashion frames, and you get both pairs of glasses for only $99 in about an hour. iMart always saves you more.
Merry Christmas from the DeTallant Carpet family to yours. May you experience all the joy that this time of year has to offer.
I'm Brenda with DeTallant Carpets. From my family to yours, wishing you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
The staff at Southern Business Machines wishes you a safe and prosperous holiday season. For all your mailroom needs, visit the Tri-State's largest showroom.
Happy Holidays!
Our goal and philosophy is to create and build a relationship before we ever even think about building a business.
iMart accepts most vision benefit plans. However, if we don't carry your plan or you don't have vision insurance, iMart will still save you 30 to 60% every day on eye exams, glasses, and contacts. iMart, eye care and eyewear for less every day.
5-1-1 versus the Indiana Hoosiers. Time now for our Prairie Farms starting lineups, brought to you by Prairie Farms. Marco Killingsworth, we talked about him, a two-time Big Ten Player of the Week. And the biggest problem, John Leskowski, for Butler, their size. Brandon Polk is their tallest starter at just 6'6".
Yeah, it's a very scrappy Butler team, but they need to be able to get the boards.
Indiana, of course, led by Mike Davis, 102-69 in his career. Of course, he led Indiana to the Final Four back in 2002. Indiana leads the series 35-12, but 10 of Butler's 12 games here, their wins have come here in Indianapolis. So they are a formidable opponent when they play Indiana here in Indianapolis. Polk jumping center against Marco Killingsworth. And we're underway.
Marco not really ready for that tap. Didn't even jump. Butler likes to run three players outside, one inside, and then a player, 20 is Polk. He comes out to set some screens.
Brandon Drone trying to go baseline, kicks it back outside.
The other thing you'll see Butler do is the weave as they go from one side of the floor to the next.
A.J. Graves out to Sheets. Avery Sheets off the front of the iron. Here come the Hoosiers.
Indiana likes to move the ball up quickly and take a quick shot if they can get it.
Mark Marshall Strickland. We talked about him at the start. Indiana avoids a turnover there. Got the ball inside the Killingsworth. I think we're going to see a lot of this tonight because this is a big mismatch.
Just backed his way in there and then crossed the middle with that favored left hand. Brandon Crone goes 6'6", 230. He's giving up about 30 pounds to Killingsworth.
Avery Sheets working against Lewis Monroe. Bruce Horan, his three-point shot, no good. Here come the Hoosiers, pull-up jumper. A.J. Ratliff can't get it to go. A little extra step by Robert Baden. Let's take a look at our Steak and Shake keys to the game, John.
Actually got those a little reversed. For Butler, it's the rebounding there. As you see it for Indiana, they've got to use their height to try to scrap for these rebounds. And three-point field goal percentage, they've got to make shots from the outside. For Indiana, they're going to rely on their inside scoring. We already saw it with Killingsworth getting that first basket.
The leading scorer for the Butler Bulldogs has the basketball right now, that being Brandon Polk. Nice work inside, but he couldn't get it to go, and we've got a foul on the play.
Personal foul, Indiana.
What is Todd Licklider's worst nightmare about this game? What could go wrong here early that could haunt him?
Well, getting behind big is the first thing, and his offense really hasn't got into the mode yet. Indiana has scouted this team very well, and watching the shoot-around this morning, they really worked against that weave and really trying to close. The second key there was to close on the shooters that Butler has and put pressure on. Butler not shooting at all. It hasn't made a field goal yet.
Right now, their all-time leading three-point shooter, Bruce Horan, 0-for-2. From the corner, Robert Baden.
Indiana take a quick shot when they can get it. Ratliff on the last play, the fast break, pulled up and took it. Indiana's got so many scores that not all of them can have a bad shooting night in the same night. So they're not afraid to put it up.
Butler working the weave. Robert Baden has started every game of his career. Tonight his 37th straight, and he is really one of the unsung heroes of this Hoosier team, John.
He is, because he can play both guard and forward. You know, with only Killingsworth as the inside player, Baden is really drawing a bigger man to guard in every ball game, but his scoring keeps improving as well.
Crone from three-point range gets Butler back in it. Their first points of the game, 5-3. Baden's got the ball again, this time over Brandon Polk.
Baden can drive, but he also hit that pull-up jumper there. He's also a three-point shooter. He's very difficult to guard offensively.
Indiana sharp early. Here's Graves from downtown. That one didn't even hit the rim, just the back of the backboard.
See the Indiana players really closing out to get to those shooters and put the hand up.
Another Butler turnover. Here comes A.J. Ratliff. Once, twice, it won't go. Marco Killingsworth, nice swat away there by Polk. Finally, a foul on the play. Bruce Horan reaching in and holding.
That sequence right there is probably Todd Licklider's nightmare,
yeah.
Four or five offensive rebounds. Watch Ratliff, a little out of control here, but gets his own rebound, misses the tap. So that's one, that's two offensive rebounds. Monroe misses, and now Killingsworth right there, and then the foul. A couple things Killingsworth will need to work on, Mike. His free throw shooting is not very good.
Just over 50% for the season.
And he also, for the center, he leads the Indiana team in turnovers. Not a good stat to have. That's caused when teams double-team him, and then he's got to pass it out. 36 turnovers for Marco Killingsworth this season.
But he is a dynamic player, that's for sure, and has made Indiana a much better ball club this season. Marshall Strickland leaves the game for Indiana. Roderick Wilmot now in the game for the Hoosiers. Indiana with an 8-3 lead here early on at Signal Fieldhouse. steal, another turnover. Here comes Baden. He loses the ball. Sheets now the other way for the Bulldogs. Nice cross-court pass to Brandon Polk. Turnovers are important, but they're only important if they lead the points.
Great defense by Graves that time. He stopped the Indiana fast break and able to start one for the Bulldogs. See how Killingsworth keeps his head up now when he gets that double team and then looking for a teammate to pass it to.
Working against Brandon Crone, squatted away by Brandon Polk. He can sky just 6'6" tall, the senior from Wichita, Kansas. Traveling on the play. Graves taking the extra step. Butler trying to hang with number 17, Indiana. This is one way to do it.
Right now, Steak and Shake is bringing back eggnog and white chocolate milkshakes and introducing new dark chocolate milkshakes. We don't hang our holiday decorations. We hand-dip them.
You can't have a steak burger without crispy edges. You can't get crispy edges unless you sear them on a hotter grill. You can't sear them on a hotter grill until you master grilling. You can't master grilling until you use the steak cuts. And without steak cuts, you can't have the steak burger.
Steak and Shake, famous for steak burgers.
It's Rogers Jewelers, just in the nick of time sale.
Your choice, only $99. This diamond fashion ring, the diamond circle of love pendant, or this pink sapphire ring. Your choice, only $99.
Rogers Jewelers, perfect gifts, perfect prices.
It looked like a bomb had exploded.
The boys' bodies were unidentifiable.
Parents wanted to see their children, and their children were gone forever.
You have to be pretty drunk to have your best friend die right next to you and not realize that you're responsible.
There's not one family in the county hasn't been touched by a DUI.
It certainly doesn't make you want to go easy on drunk drivers, ever.
If I catch you driving under the influence, you will go to jail.
It's real simple, Kentucky. You drink, you drive, you lose.
Savings add up at McDonald's. So swing by and grab a morning Mac with two slices of melting cheese, sausage, and egg, all on a toasted English muffin.
It's Rogers Jewelers, just in the nick of time sale.
The perfect last-minute gift, diamond earrings. Your choice, round or princess cut. Now only $199. Or this 1/2-carat diamond band, now only $499.
Rogers Jewelers, perfect gifts, perfect prices.
Indiana Hoosier fans in the holiday spirit here at Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis as their Hoosiers lead Butler 8-5. Marco Killingsworth going for the bucket and Butler's version of the human eraser. Brandon Polk swatting it away.
There's no easy baskets. Killingsworth beats his man, but great defense by Polk. He comes from the weak side. A great way to block that shot. Kept it in play as well. It got Butler the ball going the other way.
Junior college transfer. Indiana continuing to get the ball inside to their big man. Nice reverse layup.
That's a tough play, Mike. That's to his right hand, and it's under the basket where you have to worry about stepping on the out-of-bounds line. Killingsworth, the big man, fit through there well and got the layup.
Last year, John, when we covered a couple of Indiana games, it was clear that this guy was going to be a great player. He was just on the practice team, but his work ethic was so sound, so solid that it helped him as a player and it helped his Indiana teammates.
You get a great force in the middle. It helps every college team out there. And when you got the big guy behind you all the time.
Julian Betko from the Czech Republic originally. In the game now here. Oh, yeah, from down Avery Sheets. Another great three-point shooter. He's got 141 three-point shots that he's connected on in his career. Strickland shot.
Indiana for 34 seconds, and then the last second, Butler able to score. Watch how Killingsworth works inside. You have to keep moving. Use your arms and your body to get that position. You want that ball as close to the block as you can. And there's a quick dribble to two big steps and a reverse layup.
It's tough for Brian Ligon, number 24, to defend that, especially giving away so much weight. Here's Polk, the fadeaway jumper, good.
Butler's
trying to get warmed up now. They're a very good outside shooting team. And a well-coached team, yeah.
They've gained their confidence now.
Tied at 10.
Indiana's looking to go inside to Killingsworth as much as they can. And not looking for that three-point shot right away.
Lewis Monroe, the other transfer from the university, from Auburn University, trying to get it into his former teammate. Bounces off Marco's hands, and ball to Butler.
Number 20, A.J. Ratliff.
Butler, winner for their last five games.
Well, they're a scrappy team, Mike. They play hard. Seven of these kids from the state of Indiana, and they grew up just playing tough-nosed basketball. And they bring that to this floor, and especially when they play in an in-state school like Indiana.
Yeah, no stranger to Big Ten competition. They lost in overtime in Columbus to Ohio State earlier this year.
Number 33, Brandon.
Nice shot there by Brandon Crone. Butler with his first lead of the game. And they're on a 7-0 run. Killingsworth can't get it to go. Ball out of bounds. Hit the end line. Ball to Butler.
Good stop here. Good jump stop by Crone. And he gets the shot.
Monroe, number 33.
Everything going right for Butler now on that 7-0 run.
Yeah, Crone has scored an average of 15.3 points per game in his last four. So he has had the hot hand for the Butler Bulldogs. They lead by two here early on. Crone gets it again. He gets a step on Baden. DJ White in the game now for Indiana. That's what stopped that last penetration. Baden inside, number three, DJ White, missed the first seven games of the season with a broken left foot, came back last week to debut against UNC Charlotte, scored 8 points, five rebounds, two blocks in 17 minutes of work. Crone shot, the friendly bounce.
When you're really scoring well like Crone is, that's the kind of bounce you get off the front rim and in. DJ White, good hustle last time. He got the rebound and then beat his man down the floor to get that layup.
Robert Baden for 3 points.
Butler tries to drop low to prevent DJ White from scoring. Indiana can get the ball out to the three-point shooters. Baden hit that one.
8 of 15 of Indiana's 15 points. Baden has scored today. Here's Crone working hard against Robert Baden that time.
That's what I mean. Those are the kind of shots that you're happy if it hits the rim. That one goes in off the board.
16-15 Butler, and Errol Colloway in the game now for Indiana. Almost turned the ball over. Here's a mismatch. White over Betko. Gets his own rebound. Following the shot, and that's all hustle, John.
Just reached right up. Betko at 6'5". So giving away 3 inches to DJ White. And he is hustling. Watch the bounce in his step. For a guy who's just had a foot injury, he is not showing any tenderness. He just goes right after that ball.
Let's keep an eye on Butler's number 33, Brandon Crone. He scored the Bulldogs' last 6 points.
Switching. DJ White's outside. Earl Calloway trying to guard Ligon inside. They go right to him.
And Calloway able to draw the foul. DJ White, last year's Big Ten Freshman of the Year, showing you why on this hustle play. Back with more after this.
The holiday countdown sale at King's. Now you can buy name brand appliances, electronics, furniture, and bedding with no down payment and no interest until 2010 on select items. King's Great Buys Plus, your holiday home store.
Red hot deals on all remaining 05s at the Red Hot Red Tag Sale at Expressway Auto World. We've priced all remaining new 05s $500 below Red Tag pricing, plus You get the rebate. New 05 GMC Yukon for just $23,990. New 05 GMC Sierra Extended Cab 4x4, just $19,990. Choose a gift with every vehicle purchase and win holiday cash up to $1,000. Guaranteed lowest prices at Expressway Auto World in Mount Vernon.
Most states prohibit showing large breasts on television. Unless, of course, it's on a sandwich. The big chicken filet from Hardee's. At a third of a pound, it could be the world's biggest chicken sandwich. Only at Hardee's.
Dennis Dave Dental Group is proud to care for your family's dental needs. Our low-cost teeth whitening uses economical bleaching trays that brighten your smile. Our old ceramic crowns for front teeth completely disappears. They're bonded, giving you an incredible new look. At Dennis Safe, we accept cash, check, Visa, MasterCard, or Discover, and offer prepayment discounts and extended payments, too. Dennis Safe is proud to announce that our newest staff member, Dr. Thomas Salmon, is accepting new patients. Dennis Safe Dental Group, 4601 Baird Park Drive in Evansville. Call 812-473-1992.
It's the holiday countdown sale at King's. Now you can buy name brand appliances, electronics, furniture, and bedding with no down payment and no interest until 2010 on select items. King's Great Buys Plus, your holiday home store.
Bulldogs hanging in there against number 17, Indiana. Indiana with a one-point lead. Last time out, Butler a winner Monday night over Elon, 86-40. And look at that field goal.
Their defense wasn't bad either. Elon just 3 points in the first 17.
And then you did this game, John.
Indiana over Charlotte. Again, very good defense and great shooting from the outside to go with it. So both teams coming off really good performances earlier this week.
In his prior game to the UNC Charlotte game, Indiana tightening the screws against Kentucky in a big win.
Mike Davis has really talked about defense. Counting the four games Indiana State before, Indiana gave up over 70 points in three of those four games and lost two of them.
Here's Faith. Might have hurried the shot a little bit, overthrown, bounces over the backboard.
Since though, Indiana's only given up 53 and 54 in each of those two games. So it's one-on-one defense that Mike Davis has been stressing. And right now, Butler scores a lot of points. Let's see if Indiana can answer the call.
Marcus Nellum's in the game now, number 23 for Butler. The backboard.
Brandon Holt.
Here's Crone. He hurried that shot off the back of the iron. Back comes Indiana. Callaway.
Yeah, looks for that first quick shot. They can't get it. They bring it back out.
Maiden throws the ball away. Avery Sheets with the steal. Thought about it. Shooting the three-pointer, then move it back to his body. They started cold, the Butler Bulldogs, but since that 2-of-7 shooting early on, they've gone 5-of-7. Thanks in large part to Brandon Crone. Holt's bank off the glass doesn't go. Rebound Indiana.
Clear the side for DJ White. One-on-one.
DJ charged with the charge.
After three, DJ.
Back in on Brandon Holt.
Second foul. When you play with your back to the basket, it's hard to tell what that defender's doing. If he senses that that offensive player is coming back for the block, it's a great defensive play. He backs down, he gets hit. That's an offensive foul. DJ doesn't agree with it, but that's why you got to turn your head a little bit and see where that defender is.
Yeah, DJ, if he had turned his head, he would have seen that Pope had his feet in position. Fall away from the basketball. Indiana. Right inbounding.
Offensive. The personal foul, Butler, number three, Bruce Moran. His second personal was a team's
second foul of the game. That is not
substitution. Top Eric Sewer.
Best three-point shooter in foul trouble here in the first half.
Marshall Strickland comes out. Eric Sewer in for the good three-point shooter. There. When Markle gives the ball up, if he'll try to reestablish position right away, that's the key. As the defense relaxes just for a second, you get set and get the ball right back to him. There's the easy layup.
19-16, Indiana. Butler scoreless in their last 4 minutes and 30 seconds. Pope with a nice fingertip roll and move. First step move. He couldn't get that one to go. Butler, however, retaining possession. Graves. To Polk. He's got it.
Graves made a great pass there. He got off his feet. But he was able to bring the ball back to the same side of the floor to the open Bulldog.
His body control. There, we talked about the turnovers being a problem for Marco Killingsworth. Very careless with the basketball there.
Picked up his dribble, had nothing to do with it.
Here's Krohn for three in the corner. John, I get the feeling that Indiana's still trying to figure out the best way to attack this Butler defense.
You're right, Mike. They're starting inside with Killingsworth, but Butler seems to have figured out how to prevent him from getting those easy baskets. And Indiana's got to figure out who's open, who can take the shot.
Eric Sewer going for the steal, knocked it out of bounds. Indiana's big man has a plan. Give it to me inside. I'll get it done.
Don't tell me we don't have time to do a fancy lunch. Because now there's McDonald's all-new premium chicken sandwiches. Juicy chicken breast in my kind of flavors, like the ranch BLT and the club. Yep, they're totally five-star all the way.
Why do the Zoffs have their auto, home, and life insurance with American Family?
We have our first home, two cars, and we have a brand new baby. It's a lot of responsibility.
Our agent works very hard for us.
Our agent went through a lot of options, very thorough. It's a rarity to get the kind of service we get with American Family.
And something else appeals to the Zoffs.
We even get discounts with American Family.
Find out what you're missing. Call American Family.
American Family Insurance.
And now, Prairie Farms redefines the language of basketball.
The ball, and it's a fast break. Back in the zone, Art guarding the ball. And here comes the double team. And it's nothing but net.
Quality you can taste from Prairie Farms.
Steak and Shake's holiday milkshakes are back. Eggnog, white chocolate, and new dark chocolate. We don't hang our holiday decorations. We hand-dip them.
At Steak and Shake, we're a restaurant. You sit. I serve.
Steak and Shake.
Yes, just a couple of days away. Not to worry. Santa's going to come. Indiana with a 19-18 lead. And with so much Hoosier pride on the line, it's pretty obvious why the games have been close in the last five contests.
Butler's had great success in Indianapolis, whether it be at the Hinkle Fieldhouse or here at Conseco. Indiana can win those games at Assembly Hall. And that's why this is a very big road game for Indiana.
to get Eric Sewer off his feet. Instead, he traveled with the basketball. Mike Adamly alongside John Laskowski here as the Indiana Hoosiers rank 17th in the country, taking on Butler of the Horizon League, coached by Todd Licklider.
Indiana's changed the lineup a little bit with two big guys, Ben Allen at 6'11 and 6'9 DJ White. First time they've had two big players at the same time in the lineup tonight. See the result of offensive rebound, another possession for Indiana.
Points in the paint, 10-4 in Indiana's favor. Brandon Polk about to come back in the game for the Butler Bulldogs. Strickland. DJ getting tangled up after getting the pass. Good hands, John. Outstanding. You haven't lost a thing, man.
That was with one hand, too. You know, I was taught with two hands, but the ball's coming at you. Do what you can.
Showboat.
I'm able to grab that one. I'd rather shoot than catch passes, though. That's not my game.
Mike Davis with a concerned look on his face. Why not? Here's Sheets from three-point range. No good, but hard, tough rebound by Brian Ligon.
Good job going after that ball between a couple of Indiana players.
Graves kicking it back out to Polk, trying to get DJ off his feet.
But Indiana's recovering well and getting those hands up. Except right there, White leaves his feet. That's automatically going to be a foul. Good play by Polk.
Yeah, drawing the foul.
Personal foul, Indiana, number three, DJ White.
Both these teams concentrating on the defense, just 19 and 18, respectively. Indiana and Butler were under the five-minute mark. Both these coaches stress defense. Mike Davis giving up only 65 points a game. Todd Licklider's team only 60. So as much offense and three-point shooting as both these teams have, the real core of what they want to do is play defense, and both teams have got that done so far in this first half.
Yes, again, if you think Indiana's taking Butler lightly, not after what happened to them against Indiana State, turns out the Sycamores are a pretty good basketball team. They're with 8-0.
Still undefeated, that's right. In fact, of the four Butler losses, the only time they've been beaten by undefeated teams. So this Butler team has had a terrific year to start off.
Brandon Polk made both of his free throws, and Butler has taken a 20-19 lead. Ben Allen taking a seat, the freshman from Melbourne, Australia, who's been a big lift for Indiana this year off the bench. He goes back to take a seat on the bench. A.J. Ratliff going to the hole, feeding it to Vaden off Robert Vaden's leg. Another Indiana turnover.
Vaden thought he had a clear path to the basket. Sheets reached from behind and able to slap the ball off Vaden's leg, and there's a turnover. Watch how he comes from behind. Here's the pass. Vaden's all alone, and right there. Sheets slaps down on the ball, bounces off of Vaden's leg. Good defense.
Julian Betko in the game now for the Bulldogs.
Weave, looking for that easy shot. There it is by Graves.
Graves.
Defense gets caught up as they try to go between screens there. Indiana will try to switch that when it's a guard-to-guard switch, but Graves wide open for the basket.
Butler by three, their biggest lead of the game. Vaden inside to Killingsworth. Great job of getting position by Marco.
Yeah, showed that lead hand on the high lob pass, and once he gets it on the block or closer, he's not going to be tough to stop.
Killingsworth came into this game averaging 19.8 a game. He's got 9 already. 3:22 remaining here in the first half of play. Butler leads Indiana by one.
Tries to repost him once he gives the ball up.
He's got position on Crone.
Had to step out a step longer than he wanted to, though.
Now double team tries to cross pass. Intercepted by Graves. He pulls up.
players, he knew that probably should pass that ball out. Very wise decision by A.J. Griggs. There's the weep. When Monroe goes under that screen, that'll give Graves a chance to make that shot.
Holt gets triple teamed, gets it back out to Graves, and he buries it. 24-21, 4 points for Graves tonight.
Two quick baskets now, so he's got his confidence up. Indiana's got to stay with him and try to get that hand in his face.
Back inside to Killingsworth. So big, so powerful. 11 points for Indiana, and it's really kind of ironic. He's kept Indiana in the game with his offense. He's kept Butler in the game with his turnovers.
A couple of turnovers. Both teams shooting well. Just not a lot of shots taken so far in tonight's game. There's Bates. See how it got over that screen and got right up on Graves when he got the ball.
Thrown all alone. And Julian Betko reaching over the back. A.J. Graves from Butler. When you've got the open shots, you've got to make them, and A.J. did just that.
The fresh toasted chicken and bacon ranch sandwich from Subway Restaurants is made with tender chicken, shredded cheese, real bacon, tasty ranch dressing, and toasted on freshly baked bread. We'd say it's a sandwich eater's finest hour, but that's 59 minutes longer than it takes to devour it. Subway, eat fresh.
Subway Restaurants are helping with holiday spirit by offering a gift you can share. Stop by your favorite Subway restaurant and get two regular foot-long subs for just $8.99. Who knew the gift of giving could be so filling?
What do you need to make your mailroom more efficient?
Digital postage meters and scales, a folder inserter, an addressing and barcoding system, maybe a shredder or check signer. No matter what your mailroom needs, Southern Business Machines has it all.
We can make it as easy as 1, 2, 3.
Son, you want to get your feet off my desk?
Hi, I'm Vernon Stevens.
And I'm Sandra Siegel.
And I'm Vernon Stevens II. Call or come by today and visit Tri-State's largest mailing equipment showroom.
It's Town & Country Ford's annual Red, White, Green Tag pre-owned sales event. On every vehicle, the Red Tag has the sale price as much as 70% below the price of new. The White has the lowest possible payment, many under $99 a month. And the Green Tag has a special gift for you, a Walmart gift card up to $2,000. Our Red, White, where you save like never before on the price, on the payment, and get a great holiday gift to boot. Only at Town & Country Ford.
Some great gift ideas from Passmeyer. Spa's holiday price with 2 years free financing. A special holiday spa package included with most spas. This area's best pre-lit Christmas trees. This week at 30% off. Adorable collections of snowmen, reindeer, and Santas to deck your halls. Passmeyer's has the perfect reason for you to wish for that lump of coal, charcoal that is, this Christmas. The Big Green Egg Smoker, the world's best smoker. Duquesne Grills, cash and carry, this week only, $3.96. Are you on Santa's list from Passmeyer's? Santa knows. We're the pros at Passmeyer's Fireplace, Patio, and Spas.
Butler cheerleaders getting a little elevation here at Conseco Fieldhouse as their Bulldogs lead Indiana 24-23, 1:28 remaining in the first half. You know, pretty good rule of thumb for Indiana. When this man plays well or shoots well, Indiana wins. When he doesn't, the converse happens.
Look at the losses there, 30% and only 16 on his 3 points. We put him in our star watch today in this ball game, and he has not been able to perform. No points, only one shot in 17 minutes. He's still just a brief time off the bench. But the game plan for Indiana was to go inside, and Marshall just hasn't been the guy that's been open as the outlet passes come outside. Can't get down himself, just keep looking for that open shot. Make it when you're open.
Yeah, clearly Mike Davis's first half plan was give it to their big man, Marco Killingsworth, to take advantage of his size and power advantage. Killingsworth not in the game right now, but Strickland is. So is Ben Allen, number 21. The Australian freshman we were talking about, fading the turnaround jump shot off the back of the glass, iron, rebound, Brandon Crone. We're under a minute to play here in the first half, and the Bulldogs call timeout. They have played extremely well here, John.
Sure have. Good timeout by Todd Licklider. They get the rebound. He just set up the plays here. He might be thinking about going for 2-for-1. Denver get two possessions and Indiana just one. So if he takes a shot with about 42 seconds to go, that might allow him to get two possessions to Indiana's one.
The Butler Bulldogs in the preseason periodicals that I read picked to finish maybe fourth or fifth in the Horizon League. But look at this. Number one in assists, turnover margin, scoring, defense, turnovers. It might be a little bit better than people think.
Awful good start. You know, Ohio State, they took Ohio State to overtime. They led Michigan with 5 minutes to go and just lost by 4 points. Todd Licklider's done a great job with his Butler team. They're small in today's standards of the college basketball team, but scrappy and good shooters. That'll win you ball games.
They run that weave to perfection, that's for sure. Marcus Nellum's in the game now for Butler.
They're going to play for one shot.
Beats with the basketball. Graves for three over Marshall Strickland, who had a hand in his face that distracted him. Indiana now will get a chance for the last shot. And they're going to call timeout. Lewis Monroe kept looking back at the bench. Call a timeout. Calling a timeout.
He thought he heard Mike Davis. The shot clock really ran down on Butler that time. With 1 second, they had to take the shot.
Big Ten Conference this year is going to be mighty tough, but Indiana making an early statement, leading in these categories so far.
Lead the Big Ten in scoring and three-point field goal percentage, not only in the Big Ten, but in the country at 47%. Scoring margin well up. Assists, that's the big difference this year. Indiana's a lot more assists, and they rank number two in the country in the number of assists per game.
And after a New Year's Eve date with Ball State in Muncie, they open up their Big Ten play at home at Assembly Hall against the Michigan Wolverines of Tommy Amaker. Butler with a one-point lead, and just for the record, they are 5-0 in games this year in which they have led at halftime. Baden gets it into Killingsworth. Officials are saying that Avery Sheets is the last man to touch the basketball. Almost a great defensive stop there. 2.8 seconds left on the clock here in the first half.
That's where you want to run your out-of-bounds play and get the quick shot.